TriniGirlNatural.
Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I have a long overdue video for you today because I'm finally talking about my regimen. So my regimen is super simple, so that could be part of why I haven't really done a video, but you do deserve to know, and it will help you understand like just all the products and everything I'm doing. There is a method to my madness. So it can probably be over in one sentence. Cleanse and deep condition my hair weekly. Then I do a wash and go, and that's it until next week. I just leave it like this. So you'll see my wash day routines. I detangle first with conditioner. Then I cleanse just based on how my scalp is feeling and what I've been up to and just how my hair feels. I will either use like cleansing co-wash or moisturizing shampoo, and then I deep condition. That's the main thing. Then I would just either apply leave-in with some jelly or just do like conditioner to wash and go. And then repeat next week. I have a lot of shrinkage and I don't generally stretch my hair because I don't really care. I kind of like not having to deal with hair on my neck, but you know, I have hair. Yeah, so yeah. Midweek, I would just give it a light spritz and apply some leave-in to my part, my crown, and my hairline. You know, you wash your face and stuff and your hairline gets dry. And I've noticed that my part used to be like the most tangled part during detangling. So I've started just kind of spritzing it and adding a little bit of leave-in. And I think that's helped keep it from getting too tangled. So I do that once a week and not a lot of leave-in, just like a little bit, just as a kind of refresh midweek. I don't have a nighttime routine. I have satin pillowcases and I go to sleep. I sometimes do like a little half pineapple and just raise this part. I might want to get it out of my face so not have like breakouts and stuff. Wake up, I may do a light spritz depending on what product I use, or I might just fluff it. So what's in my spray bottle? Because I told you like I mist and stuff. I just have mostly water, a couple squeezes of leave-in. Definitely play with it to get your right proportions. And I know I'm not a measurer, but that's what works for me. So I don't want to use pure water because I want the spritz to be pH balanced for hair, which involves bringing it down from the water pH of 7 to at least something lower. You know, hopefully around 5, 5.5. So that's why I add a little bit of leave-in to pH balance the water. I will do through the week stage thing of like showing you my wash and go every morning and like what I do in the morning and stuff like that. I will do a video like that. Monthly, I would do like a tea rinse. So I try to do a tea rinse. I use the Blue Rose DC sometimes, Chai Hair Tea DC, which is a really, really great DC to just keep shedding out of control because I have really thick hair, so can't let that shedding get crazy. So I would either use that Chai Hair Tea or I would just steep a cup of tea, like black tea or green tea myself, and just put it on my scalp and let it sit for 20 minutes with like a conditioner over it to soften it. I do have a video showing that, so won't get into too much detail. And every 2 months, I try to do a protein treatment. Of course, I get lazy, I get confused, I get busy, so I don't really do it on schedule, but it really gets me straight, gets me curly in terms of getting my curls tighter, like if it's starting to look loose, because my hair, my curl pattern is kind of noodly, like, you know, just kind of long, shallow S, so it gets even more noodly and loose. I like it to be tight. It gets even more noodly and loose if I need protein. So just to get it tight and right, I will do like a protein treatment every 2 months. Since the protein is mostly for the hair and the tea is mostly for the scalp, and I want to clarify my hair and scalp before both, I just decided to combine them. So I have a video showing you how I combine them. I would use the tea treatment on my scalp, like my steep cup of tea in some hot water, not too hot, and just apply it to my scalp and then apply my protein treatment. And last but not least, I like to do a clay treatment. Again, if you follow me on Instagram, you kind of see when I do them. But I have a video as well, I'll link that up top, showing you my clay treatment. It does reduce frizz and boost my moisture levels, especially with my special mix. Again, check my video out. So my hair just feels super moisturized after it. But I don't want to mess with it too much just because it is kind of intense for your hair. Depending on how you mix it, the pH could be a bit high. So you could have some cuticle stress, let's say, from doing it. It can get really messy in the bathroom, which is a whole other drama. Don't want to clog my drains up or anything with clays. In terms of products, you guys may see that I use a lot of products, but I really don't, because when it comes down to it, I use water, aloe vera juice, honey, fatty alcohols, oils, carrier oils and essential oils, and fruit extracts and surfactants. and protein. That's pretty much all I use. So even though I may use a lot of different products, they all have the same ingredients, basically. I mean, you know, they all have different types of the same ingredient. They all have different types of oils, butters, fruit extracts, humectants. I don't use silicones. I don't use polyquats, so I try to stay away from them. I try to stick to like the water-soluble stuff. Of course, oils will tend to stick to your hair, so I am team cleansing, co-wash, and shampoo. I'm not going to put regular conditioner on my scalp either. One caveat, I avoid glycerin stylers in the winter, and also like if I go somewhere really humid like the Caribbean, because glycerin does tend to affect my hair, so dries my hair out in the winter and frizzes my hair out in the really humid weather in the summer. So glycerin is seasonal with me. And that's about it. I'm really telling you, that's it. That is my regimen. What I want to say about my regimen, your regimen, anybody's regimen, is it really is a kind of play by ear thing and just learning your hair thing. So never just stick to something like, oh, I'm just going to do this every this and that's that. You kind of go by what your hair needs. So I can tell if I want a stronger cleanser on my scalp. I can tell if I want more moisture, if I want maybe more protein. Is my shedding going up? Like, those are the things that I'm looking for. Is my breakage going up? Like, those are the things that I'm looking for every time I'm in my hair. So I'm definitely low manipulation. I definitely listen to my hair. If my hair says, girl, you better get some shampoo up in here because my scalp is itchy, that's what I'm gonna do. If my hair says, girl, you better get that top shelf she scented deep conditioner because you need some moisture, that's what I'm gonna do. And that's it. I think that's pretty much all you need. You need moisture, you need protein, control your shedding, trim your ends. Happy life. Happy and simple life for the lazy natural. So I'm so glad that I finally got this video done to let you guys know what my regimen is and let you guys know the method to my madness, because I try all those products, but you didn't know it was the same product. Because, you know, I have rules that I follow in terms of I use pH balance products and I avoid things that coat my hair. And I look for humectants because my hair is ultra low porosity. Let me know if you have any questions about my regimen down below. Let me know if you want me to do a video about how to create your own regimen. I think I pretty much mentioned it. Let me know if you have your regimen together and what your regimen is. Share, you might help me, you might help other subbies in the comment section. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!